good afternoon to all, and welcome to this session, the social session that we are going to look at the impact on VBA's model for uptake on new agri technologies. And we are going to listen to stories from the field. Now, this session will present some of the works that we have done as Agra with our VBAs and the impact of the village-based advisors model for uptake of the new agri technologies in Africa. The farmers and the VBAs will share their experience on how the model have helped in availability of yield enhancement, input, extension services at the farmers' level. It will also demonstrate how digitalization has improved extension and ensure that farmers continue to gain access to information and inputs that they need to sustainably increase production and income in spite of these unprecedented times of COVID pandemic. One of the solutions that we will be showcasing in the video is the agribot, which has improved dissemination of agricultural information and extension services through onboarding of VBAs, strategic partnership and service providers like Eka Africa, and public sector engagement with the county government in Kenya. And one of the things that we have done is to scale up the service of agribot. Partnership with public and private sector is recommended, which would also include more content from the National Kenya Agricultural Livestock and Research Organization, otherwise known as CARO. So I want, as we start, to really invite my colleague Rufaro, who is the Senior Program Officer in Extension and Capacity Building in Agra, to tell us more about our approach of the VBA model. Welcome, Rufaro.
Good morning, good afternoon. As Nixon has said, my name is Rufaro Matakazi. I work in the Extension and Capacity Building Unit of Agra. The approach that we are using, the aim is to increase awareness among farmers and catalyze the adoption of improved seeds and other yield-enhancing inputs to increase their yields. We are also working to reduce the worker-to-farmer numbers, extension worker-to-farmer numbers. In most countries, we have extension worker-to-farmer numbers of 1 to 3,000, 1 to 10,000 in really bad cases. So the approach that we use is relevant to the very smallholder farmers, because especially in the way they process information, it is breaks down the barriers between the public and the private sector. And it allows hundreds of thousands of farmers in remote villages to learn by doing and to access delivery of inputs. It has five key components, where the first component is identifying and training self-employed village-based agents. The second component is farmers and extension. We do a farmers and extension needs assessment to see what are the bottlenecks to the production. Then they do mother and baby demonstration methods to demonstrate solutions to the bottlenecks. And we are using now ICT for agriculture methodologies and technologies. And we are also working with a wide range of partners. So a village-based advisor is a self-employed agent. This includes women and youth who rapidly create demand for yield-enhancing inputs they practically teach farmers on good agricultural practices, on protection, on post-harvest management, how to access markets, they aggregate produce and link farmers to markets. The program works with the private sector. We work with seed companies, with fertilizer companies, with agro dealers, with off-takers who are linked to the VBAs. And the VBAs provide service to these private sectors on a commission, and that's how they make money and become sustainable. So basically, a VBA is a farmer. So how are they selected? They are selected by other farmers. They are selected by other farmers, the private sector, the public sector. So the basic qualifications or characteristics of a VBA are that they must have at least a little bit of education, maybe up to high school, because they are people who can be trained to train other people. They must be personable. They must be good communicators. They must be passionate about agriculture. They must be democratically selected by the farmers. And they must have the capacity to invest in small businesses. Because once they demonstrate the technologies, the farmers will now want to know, where do we get these seeds? Where do we get this fertilizer? How do we get this thing that you have taught us about? So the selection criteria includes farmers who are trusted by other farmers, mm-hmm. and they live in that village. They are willing to learn and adopt new technologies. They are willing to share knowledge with other farmers. They must have at least some technical capacity and entrepreneurial tendencies. And we really are pushing the gender angle. They must be able to work with all genders. We are trying to reach a 50% male and female in this election. So I said they are picked from farmers, but they are trained by the public sector, they are trained by the private sector, they are trained on the good agricultural practices, crop protection, post-harvest, any other critical things that they need to know. The training is very practical, it's in the field. They are also taught how do they teach other farmers. So this helps, and each VBA usually trains 150 to up to 300 farmers. So that's how the system works. So after you teach the VBAs, we also link them with the private sector companies that are available in the region, in the area. We link them with the public sector officers that are there in case they ask hard questions they cannot answer. So that they always have the knowledge. And we have started the last 2-3 years program to digitize the VBAs. And this is critical because it provides relevant technical information through smartphones, through videos that are relevant to the farmers. We know farmers learn by seeing, learn by doing. So this approach captures all those aspects. At farmer level, we can send bulk SMSs for specific things that they need. Like there's an outbreak of fall armyworm. This is the chemical that is working in the area. Where can you get the chemical? So this is where we are now. We have several programs that we have started that are working, and we are going to learn how the VBAs are working through these programs. And finally, to just make sure that they are sustainable, a lot of the VBAs have started to run businesses in input supply as agro dealers, as agents of seed companies, or even agents of agro dealers. They are output aggregators. They supply technologies for resilience. So they are making a little bit of money, and we announced studying these models to see how we can actually improve them. How can the digitalization facilitate these models? Will they be able to reach many more farmers? But what we are going to learn today is how this system works and how it is impacting farmers. And finally, the several governments are institutionalizing the VBA approach. In Burkina Faso, the model is already adopted, and the government is putting money into the approach. In Ghana, the model has been adopted, and they are working on the regulations for making sure that the system works. And in Mozambique, there are several provinces that are also adopting this. So we are looking at all this to make sure that the system is sustainable. So we have the private sector, we have the public sector working with the VBAs, providing services to farmers, and the digitalization is to make that service efficient. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Rufaru, for that. I think so many things that you have said in a very few minutes, and to explain the VBA model and especially the part of the digitization that enables effectiveness of the VBA model. Now we want to encourage participants to submit their questions on the Q&A that we will respond to. But now I also want to invite you to watch some of the testimonials that are coming from the VBAs and the farmers. So we'll play the video showing the testimonials of the testimonials from the farmers and the VBA.
A public extension service provision that is funded by the government. So we have extension service providers from the county level to the sub-county level down to the ward level that are able to reach the farmers. And recently we have had an engagement with some partners from Africa and another project called the Local Development Research Institute, LDRI, who introduced a model of extension service for the farmers that involves the use of farmers. So we train farmers to train other farmers. So it has been able to reach up to 20,000 farmers.
I became a VBA in February 2019. I was introduced to ARDLI by the extension officer of my ward, and we were trained by the ARDLI, and we were taught about on how to volunteer to help the farmers on how to improve the productivity to their farm.
Our project had three main objectives. One was on using the VBAs as a tool or as an extension to the information so that they could reach the farmers. Then two, on regenerative agricultural practices, adoption by the farmers. And then the agribot came in on the third front, which was dissemination of information to the farmers, stakeholders, and the county officials.
I thought that it is a very good idea, because currently in Kiambu we have a scarcity of staff, and reaching farmers it's tedious and a bit difficult, because for example I'm all alone in a representing a ward.
I am a VBA with over 700 farmers, of which I've been able to register 510 farmers on the agripot, and I have accumulated them over 1 year. We have several challenges as farmers in this area, one being unbearable rainfall. The seasons are not like they used to be. We also have a problem as the maize farmers. The fall armyworm is really affecting the maize, so that's really a huge problem. And we also have a problem with our soils. Our soils are very acidic, as you can see, because of the tea. Tea requires very acidic soils, so it affects the other crops.
Our partnership with Agra started when we realized we had similar objectives. One, in terms of being able to support farmers better, being more productive and increasing their income. And so partnering with Agra, one was to get industry expertise and learn from them, but also at the same time be able to really understand what are the challenges and how do we address them using technology.
One of the challenges that I observed among the VBAs and the farmers when they were trying to adopt the chatbot is the fact that most of the VBA or some of the VBAs were using feature phones. And for feature phones, for you to access Agribot, you had to use the messaging app. And sometimes the messaging app was a bit slow in responding, such that most of the farmers would actually give up in the process of registering themselves.
The bot is structured in a way that farmers can access it through SMS, through Telegram, and also through WhatsApp. So the interaction means that they're using all these different channels to get information and also to ask for information.
Now we have about 900 VBAs that are on the platform, and they are now registering their farmers, not on a book, not on a piece of paper, but on a platform. They put in their details. It's a profile that they put in for their particular farmers. And so by registering, we've seen at least some VBAs registering up to 700 farmers. And now this has grown to about 50,000 farmers in the two counties that we serve.
I came to know about Agribot through Agra and Microsoft. Beleni tulikuwa tunafanya door to door, unaenda door to door kutafuta wakulima. Lakini kutoka Agribot wakuje, at least uko na ile message, unatuma message moja, which is free of charge. Sasa hiyo message ukituma inafikia kila mkulima. Now it's very easy to give them information.
In the same agripot kuna messenger weather forecast. In that weather forecast you can be able to plan yourself wakati utatafuta utapanda, wakati utapalilia. Basically it is a good program.
Farmers run by doing and also by seeing. Because when a lot of writing may not have a lot of explanation, but the pictures and maybe videos, that one would be more easy for the farmers to grasp.
For us as Microsoft, we really want to partner with governments, partners with agribusinesses, international organizations to see how technology can play a role in accelerating the innovation space, but also in terms of being able to be effective in the interventions that governments and other institutions are making directly to the farmer. Because at the end of the day, the aspect is on farmer income and farmer productivity.
Video that we are going to play is our approach to the VBA model, and the video looks at the business opportunity that are available to the VBA, including making money from a range of services which include sales of seeds and fertilizer. So we'll play that second video.
Knowledge is power. Empowering Africa to benefit from an agricultural transformation requires that farmers get access to the information, skills, and inputs that enable them to maximize their yields and incomes. To get this information right to the fields where the farmers are, AGRA uses the VBA, or Village-Based Advisors Model. A VBA is a kind of lead farmer who is selected by Ministry of Agriculture Extension agents together with farmers in his or her village. VBAs can also make money from a range of services, which include sales of seed and fertilizer, which offers opportunities for employment in the agribusiness space. Increasingly, VBAs are also being recruited to teach farmers how to improve the quality of grain they bring for sale to buyers, thereby reducing post-harvest losses.
He has to come and advise me, okay, it's time for us to do this. So with the help of him, I think I became more enjoyable, and then I see that I'm improving.
Seeing is believing. With the farmers having on-the-field demonstrations and trying improved products for themselves, recommended by people they know, there is increased uptake, increased productivity, and improved lifestyles.
Akisa ile mwalimu alikuja akatufundisha kupanda kwa line, tunawachanisha begu, kusema kweli tumeona tofauti.
Tumefikia wakulima 100 farmers. Na inadiki 3 quarter wamepanda hii mahindi. Juu nilikuwa nimeweza kuuza 300 packets kwa wakulima 120.
AGRA will continue to work with governments to complement their capacity to deliver homegrown solutions for African farmers that move agriculture from a struggle to survive to a livelihood that thrives. The results speak for themselves.
Thank you very much. That was the second video that basically talks about opportunities, the business opportunities available for the VBA. Our last video is from, we recorded in Mozambique, and this video shows how VBA use demonstrations as a vital way of showing farmers the advantage of improved agricultural technology. That is that will be our last video.
The VBA is a village-based agent. First of all, this man must be local with a good reputation. This is a person who is respected. When he talks, people respect him.
Primeiro fez uma formação para os produtores. Depois nós viemos disseminar aquelas práticas. Os próprios técnicos também têm vindo a acompanhar o nosso trabalho. através de eu ajudo a comunidade através de palavras e mesmo ação. Em vez de só falar que vamos fazer isso, eu levo a enxada, através da enxada, então explico as comunidades.
90 centímetros?
Antigamente era que não estava sendo medido em compasso, sei que era cavalo, abrir copas, de qualquer maneira. Agora já está a mudar, já existe uma diferença. A diferença é o seguinte, compasso antigamente que nos vinham fazer, já é diferente com este atual. Sim, existe uma diferença, porque esse que nós temos em medição de agora está se evoluindo cada vez mais. Bom ensinamento esse.
E o adubado?
É bom porque o senhor Alberto está aqui perto e está nos ensinar como produzir na machama.
The key challenge is that the agro dealer can't reach farmers within the village because he is in his shop. To sensitize farmers is quite difficult for him. This project has advantage to create these village-based agents because beyond the mother demos they develop, the farmers experimented by themselves the importance of the seed, and then farmers can go and to look at the VBA for the seed. This linkage is the key of this project to strengthen the value chain from the farmer to the market.
Então, o sucesso também é quando eu ajudo os camponeses a ter boa prática de agricultura. Esse é o sucesso.
Thank you very much. So you have seen from the videos how we have been able to use the model of the VBA and the testimonies from the VBA themselves and the farmers on how VBA model is working really to enhance extension services to the farmers. But we also seen how digitalization has improved extension and ensure that farmers continue to gain access to information and input that they need to sustainably increase their productivity and income. So this session, I want to open it up for questions. We have already answered a few questions that we have seen on the chat, but we have about 2 minutes remaining for any person who would want to ask a question to us on the VBA model and the digitization on VBA. So over to you. So there's a question around what challenge have you run into with literacy and language barrier? And how have you overcome those? We want to invite my colleague.
Okay, so the few questions that are here. The challenge of language, because we are working with people from the communities who speak the same language, who are trained by public sector extension workers from the same communities, they use the local language. So language is not a problem. There's another question on criteria of selecting the VBAs. I talked a little bit about this in the opening remarks. The VBA is a farmer who is selected by other farmers, who must be personable, who must be able to communicate, who must have a little bit of education so that they can be trained to train other farmers, who he has a passion to adopt technologies and can also help, is also willing to help others to develop. The other question was, will technology help village-based advisor model? Absolutely. Without technology, the VBAs are working from farmer to farmer to help the farmers they work with. But with technology, they can send messages. If the farmers have specific issues, they also send messages to the VBA. So this is making the system work. So the VBA is linked to the farmers, more linked to the farmers, is linked to the private sector companies that are providing the inputs, is linked to the public sector extension workers in case they get hard questions that they don't know what to say. So that's how the technology is helping the VBA. The platforms that we are using now provide even weather information, provide pest outbreak information that they share immediately with the farmers, and even solutions on what to do when you get such a pest. So these are some of the things that we are working with technology. The issue of telephone penetration within some of the communities is still critical, but what we've realized is a lot of the farmers have even feature phones. So where they don't have a smartphone, they are being sent SMS messages. Where they have smartphone, they can even be shared videos from the different platforms. Thank you.
Yeah, on the other issue of the internet also, we plan to work with the telcos to see how to extend the internet to the various rural areas where internet is not reached, so that we see how much we can, you know, help the farmers with the connectivity in partnership with the telcos and the regulator, telecom regulators of the different countries. The last question I see here is how much is a VBA paid, and who funds the cost of the VBA, and for how long? And is it based on whatever commission they earn from seed fertilizer sales?
The VBAs are not paid anything so far. They are making money by increasing their productivity. They are given inputs for conducting the mother demos. So they are given all the inputs for the mother demo conducting. So they increase their yields. They make money from selling inputs to other farmers on commission from either agro dealers or seed companies, fertilizer companies. They make money from aggregating produce that they sell to the output markets. They are also making money from selling seedlings, nurseries for trees, for vegetables, day old chicks. So a lot of them are doing a lot of other things because they've seen that there is a need in the communities. In Malawi, for instance, some of the VBAs, who are called CAAs, are actually even selling building materials because the farmers have realized this person goes to town many times, so they can send them to sell so many other things. But that's how it is working so far.
Yeah, thank you so much, Ufaro, and thank you very much for all the participants who are able to join us. We are 2 minutes past the time, and we want to thank you so much for joining us, and I hope that you have learned something about our VBA models and how we are using, digital to really make this model more effective in terms of pushing information, pushing knowledge to our farmers, and also to help them be able to be more productive in their farm. So we want to thank you for joining us, and we are here as Agra to continually engage with our partners and our stakeholders to be able to help really smallholder farmers to perform better and to also grow agriculture in Africa. Thank you very much for joining us. And thank you also, Rufaro, for being a very good companion in this one. And thank you, and see you next time.
Thank you so much, and bye.
Bye.